What's up, everybody? Jim Cavale here from Influencer, and today we're at Rupp Arena, home game four, and I'm with Eric Lindsey, the Associate Director of Media Relations here. And Eric, when you had a basketball program like Kentucky, it means you've got more than 50% of your guys probably going on to play pro ball. And I know Coach Cal preaches, do everything like a pro, play, practice, eat, train, but that also means do media and branding like a pro.
Exactly. That's the thing that I love the fact about Coach Cal is, you know, we want them to get a college experience here, and it is about the college experience, but we don't hide the fact that, you know, these guys, their aspirations are to make it to the next level, to be a professional. And so we treat everything we do here as if they're a professional when they get here. And that's across the board. I mean, that's whether we're talking about preparing for a game and training for a game, training like a pro, to the media experience they have. I mean, I would be shocked if any other program in the country has the type of media following that we have. I mean, we get guys that come back here 2-3 years later that have dealt with it on a daily basis in the NBA, and they're like, you know, we didn't like it at the time, but we're so glad that you guys put us through what you did, because this stuff is so easy and we're prepared for it. And it branches over to social media. I mean, we want them from day one when they get in here to brand themselves and to tweet into Facebook and Instagram like a pro.
Well, I think that's a great point, and it's funny, you said you wonder if anybody has a bigger following, but the reality is, at Influencer, we run all the followings of the Power 5 teams, basketball and football, and nobody does. I mean, this place and this brand has a bigger following than really any basketball program in college sports, and that's a responsibility. And what I love about your strategy here is you teach the players to tell their story on a daily basis on their social media channels, which is a strong foundation for if they do get to that next level and want to monetize it.
Exactly, and I think, and you guys have been, you've been great in sort of opening my eyes to that too. When I took this job, you know, I've been with UK for 10 years, but when I took this specific role as a sports information director, one thing I wanted to do is improve our social media, and so I put all my effort into our Kentucky men's basketball following, and Coach Cal already, you know, his thing was already taken off, and we had helped grow that to what it was, but we were so focused on that, we kind of lost sight a little bit of the players. One thing that I've, you know, with your help, is we've really tried to focus on is it's Kentucky basketball is not just that Kentucky basketball handle. We're not just Coach Cal's brand. It's the players too. And so we've tried to really expand that. It's not just people following us, it's people following them. Everybody is telling the story of Kentucky basketball, and those players are telling the story of Kentucky basketball. The same way as when we're telling the story, it's helping their brand as well.
Yeah, and it's a true thing. And when I said earlier, y'all have the biggest following in all of college basketball, that means that when you add up all the followers, the unique followers of all your current players, let alone your alumni and your recruits, the following is bigger than any other sum in any other program. And so as you teach them to tell your story, what tools are you using? I know you're using Influencer, but just to have a strategy to create content, get it in the hands of the players so that they can actually be good at it, and it's not something that is too far of a reach.
Right, as you mentioned, content, and it's sort of a phrase that we use around here with our sports video staff, our photographers, content is king. It's what drives everything. It's what tells the story. We give them practices that it's best to use on social media, things you should do, things you should not do, but the best thing we can do and the best thing we can try to help them and educate them and build their brands is to help provide that content. I mean, there's gonna be unique things and situations where we can educate them on how, hey, this is what you should be doing from your profiles, but one thing that we're trying to do a better job of across, you know, whether what it's what I'm doing with our sports video department or our photographers and what we're working with you guys on is being able to get that content and put it in their hands. Because again, you know, our Twitter following on Kentucky basketball, you know, we have over 500,000. Coach Cal's got 1 million, but you know, that's 1.5 million. If we can get it into their hands as well, and they've got another 100,000 followers here that maybe aren't following Kentucky basketball, or another 50,000 followers here, let's get that content to our fans. And the best way to do that, you know, working with Influencer, and then we've got another system with our photos to be able to help get that stuff out. I mean, that's the best way to help them build their brand and help get content to our fans.
So Coach Cal, obviously the leader here, and it all starts with leadership. We all know that. I'm sure you have peers who might work at programs that maybe aren't as proactive. Coach Cal is very proactive, and he seems to get it. Not only what he's done with his personal Twitter account and CoachCal.com, but when it comes to you guys bringing me in to speak to the team and some of the things he said, it's just clear he gets it. How big is that for you to have these initiatives here and have your leader really from top down preach it?
I love it. I mean, from day one when he came in here, that was actually, it was sort of a coincidence. He came in here, had the job for a few months, and that's when Twitter just started blowing up a little bit, and he was one of the first to get into it. And he has since that day has embraced social media. And you're right, I mean, you have coaches nowadays that don't want their guys on social media, that think it's a distraction. We try to look at it from a different point of view. There's certainly some negatives to social media, but there's negatives in anything you do. There's a lot more positives to social media, a lot of things you can do You know, we've talked about building a brand, but it also can help people. It can motivate people. It can inspire people. And that's what Cal does it for, and that's what he tries to tell our guys to utilize it for, to uplift others. You don't have to get on your social media and look at all the people that are tweeting at you or leaving all the comments. You know, that can be a little bit of the distraction, but it's about if you can inspire others, if you can bring good to people through your following, do it.
In the end of the day, every college sports team, including Kentucky, is like a national brand, and the individual players, recruits, former players, they're all affiliate channels. They represent, in this case, Kentucky basketball, and y'all are doing such a good job of partnering with your athletes, your former athletes, your recruits, to empower them to grow their brands while continuing to grow yours. And I just want to commend you on that, because that is proactive right now in college sports, and I wish you nothing but success as you move forward.
Well, I appreciate hearing that from you. I mean, we're trying to do our best, but I got to thank you for what you've done to help us get to that point too, and look forward to seeing where it's going.
Thanks, brother. I appreciate it.